Hello. This is my Ghostbusters Lego car. This is one of the most talked about things in the background, and I'm using this as inspiration today for a Copilot tutorial or for Power Automate. Let's take a look at what's possible. I'm going to put this down before I drop it and break it. What I'm going to do is take you through a use case that looks a bit silly because we're working with a ghost sighting here. So we've got a form where people are going to submit that they've seen a ghost. And what we're going to do is build a flow to post a notification in Teams. Now, as much as this is hilarious and fun, this is actually a really common use case that people use, not with the ghosts so much, or at least they don't come to me if that's what they want to do, for something like a visitor registration form. So any concept here where you've got someone submitting a form and you want some kind of notification, this is going to work for you. So here's my Microsoft Forms form. We've got what color was the ghost, where did you see it, and other details. I've just kept that nice and simple. So let's take a look at the brand new Copilot in Power Automate, along with the brand new designer that goes with that. And this allows you to describe your flow in natural language. What we're going to do here is describe what we want it to work. So it's actually going to give you a couple of examples to start with, but I've tried this a couple of different ways and you get essentially the same result. So I could say when someone submits a form, and you can see as I start to type it, you can see one of the ones that I've tested out before. I'll come to that in a second. When someone submits a form, post a message in Teams. You can do it the other way around. You can say post a message in Teams when somebody submits a form. You can see there that I've tried something else in the past, send a message in Teams when someone submits a form on the ghost sighting form. I've found so far that that level of trying to name the specifics won't get you any further than just doing the basics. So I would suggest just describe that basic automation, and then we click generate. So what this does is builds the flow out for you. Now this is a nice simple flow, but there's some core components here that are quite a learning curve in the past that now aren't an issue at all. So here's the suggested flow, the trigger when a response is submitted on my form. So far, so good. This is what the flow will do. This is the piece that's a little bit counterintuitive if you don't know how flow works, that you have to sort of go, the form is submitted, get the response, but Copilot knows that for you. So this is where we're getting a really good lift in getting started much quicker, because this is what stumps people a lot of the time. Post a message, looks so good. All right, now we can give it feedback. If it's not what you're looking for, I would encourage you to use the thumbs up and thumbs down on all these Copilot experiences. I know that Microsoft is paying attention to those things. Review my connected apps and services. So I've got a login and a connection here to Microsoft Forms and Microsoft Teams. I've used these before in this environment, so they're authenticated. If it's your first time, you might just have to click connect and go through the sign in and authentication process. Now, this is where ideally I would like to be able to say when it's this form, post in this channel. I'm hoping we're going to get to that. But for now, you're getting this experience here where you're starting out with a bunch of red warning errors, which I, you know, don't particularly like. But here's how we can solve that really easily. What you want to do, because you're working with Copilot here, is straight away go to the Copilot on the side rather than trying to deal with it in this designer here. So it's giving us that information. Copilot is saying, hey, I've done the structure for you, but to get it ready, you need to finish setting up these actions. Okay, nice and calm. Don't worry about all the red signs. I'm going to click on the first one here. So then it says, pick a form. So which form? So this is actually now taking me quite happily step by step through the process in a way that is certainly much easier than starting from blank. I've only got one form in this environment. It's the ghost sighting form. Oh, look, all my red errors are cleared there. Progress. Okay, next. Get response details. As much as you don't have to know this, I'm still going to explain the concept here. Flows generally need, you have an action or trigger or something that happens. So when that response is submitted, that's good. But then for the flow to be able to use that information, it has to do this get action. So this is a common thing you'll find as you're building out flows, that you need to sort of add another step. And once you get this, it's okay, but you need to get that detail in order to then use of the information. So we want to know what was the location and what was the color. So we need to add that extra step in there. As I said, I do love that Copilot has added that in and you don't need to know it. So again, which form this feels like double handling, but we're still saying when a form is submitted, then get the details of the response, and you just need to connect those pieces by putting that in there. Let's hope Copilot can kind of intuit that and be able to do that for us in future. 2 out of 3. So far, so good. Post the message in a chat or channel. So what I can do here is post as a user, so the user who's running the flow. The flow bot is a better way to do it because it's just a generic sort of card that comes up rather than it being when it's a form that someone on the outside of the organization is filling in. You want it to just come through as a bot kind of message notification rather than from the person. But you can choose the others if you've got different use cases. Post in. So now we're going to go through and it's going to give me options. Do I want to post it in a channel or a group chat? I'm going to put it in a channel here. And now we choose the team and the ID of there. So it's our Firehouse HQ for Ghostbusters. And the channel is the Ghost Sightings channel. So what I've done here, and this is actually what I've done with a visitor registration form in the past, is I've had something where I've actually got a specific channel where those notifications go in, but you could send it to a group chat, you could send it to the general channel. Having a channel for notifications that people can monitor and have their alerts on and things is actually quite good. Now all we need to do is put in the content of the message. And this is this brand new flow designer. If you've used it in the past, it looks quite different and it's much easier to use. So what we're going to do is a ghost has been spotted. Now you can use some fonts and things here. So we could sort of make this a bigger font. We could change the color. So let's make this kind of a nice purple. Oh, it's a highlight of a color. We don't want to do that. You can undo that. I actually want the font color to be bigger and I want that to be bold. So this is rich text. So you can actually sort of put these things out in the alerts there. What we want to do now is bring dynamic text in from that form submission. So you'll remember we had the sighting of the ghost as the color. And what else did I have in here? Let's go back to my form. I had the what color was it, where did you see it, and other details. So we can put in, what I'm going to do first is just put in the placeholder things. I'm spelling color the Australian way and it's going to give me a spelling error, but still. Color, location, and then let's put an extra line in here, other details. So what I can do now, let's just get rid of that, is put in the dynamic text. So what this allows you to do is select information that's come from the form. So we've got these little icons on the side here. I can use a power effects expression. I'm going to use this to enter data that's come from that previous step. This is a really, really nice interface now. So you'll see that there are different steps in here. This is the when the new response is submitted step, and this is the get response details. And you can see this is the one that's doing the work of bringing the information in. As you build out more complex flows, it's good to name the stages to be sensible things that you can follow, and always be mindful as you're looking for that dynamic text to see which section it's coming from. But for now, nice and simple. So the color is the answer to the what color was it question. The location, let's put a space in there, I can just go back in here, is the where did you see it, and other details is other details. This is nice and easy now. All right, now you'll notice that the title of my flow is the actual description that I put in, so I'm going to change that to be ghost sighting notification and save this flow. You can actually save the flow at any step along the way, even if you've got errors in it, which is a new and very beneficial thing. I am loving the beauty of that. Did you see the save icon in there? It was a very beautiful old school representation of what a floppy disk used to look like. We can also use this to add other steps. So we could say also send an email notification. So we can use the Copilot to build out additional steps. Let's see how it goes with this. Added this action. Okay, this is looking good. Validating my permissions to use the Outlook connector to send an email. So, all right. Now it's added it in that stage. That's okay, but we can do the same thing here. So this is now my send an email. You'll see it's actually pulled in some other things. It's actually pulled in the same stuff from the post a message in Teams into the send an email. I do quite like that. I feel like something might have gone wrong here with my location. Let's just add that in. So we want to see the where did you see it? I might have just missed, I don't know what I did wrong there. So we'll do that. And then I'm going to go into my email, and it's actually replicated the whole thing. This is a whole lot less work than building it. I'm actually very impressed with this. And then save, watch for that cool icon again. Look at that. It's like a proper picture of a floppy disk. I'm very easily entertained. All right. I think that's good to go. So we can test it or we can run it. So what I'm going to do here is actually the one thing, because I've got so overexcited about it creating the email for me that I've forgotten to do, send an email to, and I haven't put the person's email address in there. So what I'm going to do is just put in my demo email address in there. And then I think we are good to go. Let's just save that again because I can't get enough of the save icon. So let's give it a test. What I'm going to do is go back into my form. Now, if you want to give this a go yourself, make sure that if you're setting up your Microsoft form, when you go into the collect responses section here, make sure that you've got this anyone can respond. By default, it will sort of put it inside your organization. You don't want to have to be logging in and mucking around with that. All right. So let's preview, and I'm going to have a ghost sighting. So what color was it? It was green. Where did I see it? New York Public Library. And I'm going to say it had a mouth full of hot dogs. This is too much fun. Okay, submit. And now what we should see is my flow working. We should see a notification in Teams. Oh, I just heard a notification. I can see my little ding here in the emails. Let's check that. Ghost sighting has been spotted. Color green. I'm getting something wrong with that location, so we might have to have a look at that. And if I go in here in my ghost sightings, there it is as well. So there's clearly still something wrong with this location. Let's give this another go. We'll pop that back in there. Where did you see it? Seems to be okay. Send an email. Where did you see it? Let's try saving up here and seeing if that makes a difference. Every time I save, it seems to disappear. Weird. So there's something wrong with this. It doesn't seem to want to pick it up. Let's just go back here and go into edit in the old designer. Bonus troubleshooting advice here along the way. Let's see if I can get it to work in the old designer. So I'm going to go into my send an email action. Location. So it's doing something strange in there. Let's just get rid of all of that and put in the where did you see it there and see if that's going to help. And same in the Teams message. What color was it? Location. Where did you see it? Save that. Okay, let's see what that actually looks like back in the new designer here as well. See if it's actually kind of picked it up. Okay, that looks better. So I don't know, look, maybe there was a ghost. All right, let's try again. This one is blue. We saw this one on Park Avenue. And the other details, it was huge. And let's submit this and see how we go. Wait for that email notification and Teams notification to come through here. Let's go into Teams. There we go. All right, now we're working. Blue, Park Avenue, huge, and there is my email. So there you go. What we've got here is a very, very good tool in its very, very early stages. I'm going to be keeping an eye on this and refining it. Have a go. Let me know what your experience of this is like. Let me know what else you'd like me to test. If you'd like to see more of this kind of stuff, of testing out real use cases with Copilot or Ghostbusters use cases with Copilot. Thank you so much for watching.